registrations, etc., etc., etc. You will not do tenders that you cancel when they don't go your way. You will put information out so people are fully aware, where are we, how are we going to get there, what's the timeline, the roadmap, etc. Because the EC has demonstrated a complete disinterest in doing things properly, we argue that they are likely to use a shortcut, and that shortcut could bring us problems, if not in this election, in subsequent elections. Remember, they said they came to meet a mess. They said the system that they came to meet was so bad that they had to throw it all away and buy a new one. Yet, they have 81 IT professionals who have been sitting there since that thing was procured. Why are you at this stage that you are claiming you want to repair that system, doing things that are even worse than the previous administration? Because at least the previous administration commissioned an audit of the system and were given a path. What independent audits have you commissioned? Why is that the people that you've brought on board as consultants to help you navigate the procurement process had actually now been exposed as people with contracts in the EC? You've all heard the issue of Fair Green and their famous CEO whose company is trying to get business at the EC, but at the same time is advising the EC how to implement the system. Now, when somebody comes to you who has an interest in getting your money and getting a contract, and he tells you your existing system is completely useless, throw it away, how can any objective, sensible person say this is rational? So these are the questions that we believe you must put to the EC. And you must force a national debate, not only because this money should not be thrown away. This is money that can do so much good. We're talking of millions of dollars. Millions of dollars. If you share this money to everybody in Ghana, they'll get $5. That's how crazy the situation is. So it's a significant amount of money. Now, on top of that, there are huge projects we can do in this country. We are waiting for China to bring us money to go and do roads. Right? So, that is a problem. But on top of that, it's also the integrity of our elections and maintaining the free and fair nature of those elections. I think it's behoving on all of us to compel the EC to do the right thing.